Hey there, welcome to the RSPCA. Nice to be out here once again, and a very special dog to introduce you to tonight. This is Cookies, and Cookies is in fact deaf, but that doesn't make her a problem to take on as a family pet, and we'll be talking about that shortly. But let's start with some rainfall figures for the past 24 hours, and the showers started to break down during the day, but there were still some good falls during the night. 6 millimetres on Rottnest Island since this time last night, 4 millimetres at Gosnells, and Perth has had 3 millimetres, and that takes our total for the month to 34 millimetres. The maximum temperature today was 18.4. That was at 9 minutes to 2. The overnight minimum was 8.6 at 21 past 7 this morning. At the moment, it's under 15 degrees. The winds are west-northwesterly at 7 kilometres an hour. The barometer, 1,022.5 hectopascals and rising. Relative humidity, 64%. Daytime temperatures, cool in the hills, just 14 at Bickley and 15 at Carnet. The highest was 19. That was recorded at Gosnells. For the state, 36 at Lumberoo was the highest maximum, along with West Roebuck. 13 was the lowest at Katanning and Lake Grace, and the cold spot last night was Yealeary with a minimum of 0.5 of a degree. Marie Daniels from RSPCA WA has joined me to talk a bit about Cookies. How did you acquire Cookies?
Cookies simply came to us through the pound, and she's been here at the RSPCA Animal Care Centre for 7 months now, so we're really keen to find her a beautiful home.
And do you feel the deafness has been a block?
Possibly it has. I think possibly people might not know what they need to do with a deaf dog, but really there isn't a lot of difference. Dogs do learn through visual cues. She's actually a really smart dog, and she's got great capacity to be trained and to kiss. So people just need to really concentrate on building an extra strong bond and lots of trust with her.
And there are skills that really a lot of people should be training their own dogs with.
That's right. There's nothing different that we'd be doing with Cookies. It's everything that we would recommend for any new dog going into any family.
And she is a large dog, need big fences, and you're also concerned about the age of children.
That's right. Because she is deaf, she can be easily startled. So it's important that she goes to a family with more adult children, 16 and above, just to remove that little stress factor for her and ensure that she has a calm environment.
And you have offered some incentives for the people who adopt to Cookies.
That's right. We really want to help Cookies settle in really well. So she comes with free dog training for both level 1 and level 2, and that will just help the new owners really bond with her and give them some extra support during that training period.
So if you come out tomorrow, you could be going home with Cookies.
Absolutely. She's Cookies and Cream. She's just a delight.
Marie, thank you very much. We'll move on to more weather now. And we were really lying between major fronts, as the series of satellite photographs show. So most of the showers contracted to coastal areas of the Southwest Land Division. Up till 9 this morning, the best fall was 20 millimetres at Albany, 13 millimetres at Black Cat Flat, just to the east of Albany. And since 9 this morning, 2.6 millimetres from one of the gauges near Margaret River. The chart is showing another cold front moving towards the southwest corner of the state. That should arrive late in the day. So a strong wind warning has been issued for coastal areas from Two Rocks around to Israelite Bay. The rainfall model is suggesting the showers will persist over the lower west district and the southwest district. They should increase as the day goes on, and then they'll extend into the southwest land division during the course of the day, and there may be some thunderstorms around the southwest. The state temperatures is pretty warm up in the north, with the sunshine returning to the Kimberley region, 35 degrees for the major centres there. Down in the southwest with the showers, 17 in Albany and Bunbury, and the showers should be pretty late in the day for Esperance. Around the nation, a shower or two in Hobart and Brisbane tomorrow, a possible shower in Adelaide and in Cairns. Hobart's expecting 13 as a top, as is Canberra, and up in Darwin, 33. Strong wind warning for local waters. North to northwesterlies are 20 to 30 knots during the day. South to southwesterly change in the evening of 20 to 25 knots. Seas and swell both between 1.5 and 2.5 metres. High tide's a bit under 1 metre, 24 minutes to 4 in the morning. Low tide, 0.7 of a metre at 28 minutes past 5 in the evening. Forecast for Perth is for showers increasing in the afternoon and the evening. We'll have moderate to fresh north to northwesterly winds ahead of a fresh south to southwesterly change in the evening. The minimum should get down to 9 before a top tomorrow of 19. Then it clears up pretty quickly by Friday morning. A mostly sunny day Friday, but a cold start, 5 and a top of 18. Saturday should be partly cloudy, 7 to 19 degrees, and Sunday should be sunny with a minimum of 6 and a top around 21 degrees. After that, it looks like the showers will return early next week. That's it from me and Cookies this evening. Hope you're finding a home for him tomorrow. See you later.